having realized that the trigonometric functions that we have studied earlier were needed to be revised, we come over to some new way of defining these things. First of all, before we take up anything else, we define what are the angles, in particular their signs. That is, when we take up a circle, this is the origin, this is OX, the starting point, this is Y axis. Suppose the radius is A. We take up this to be 30 degrees, we take up unit circle. Unit circle means OA is equal to 1 unit and P, this is 30 degrees, this AP, that is the arc of the unit circle from A to P, will be equal to, well, 180 degrees is equal to pi radians. Therefore, 30 degrees will be equal to pi by 180 into 30. That will be equal to pi by 6 radians. Therefore, this is equal to pi by 6 radians. If we move further to this position where this angle is 45 degrees, then this arc, the arc length will be equal to pi by 4. When we take up 60 degrees, this arc length will be equal to pi by 3. At 90 degrees, it will be equal to pi by 2 radians. So this is 90 degrees, this is equal to pi by 2 radians. Similarly, at 120 degrees, it will be equal to 2 pi by 3. Pi by 2, that is the angle we are taking up in positive direction, anti-clockwise direction. At 135 degrees, this will be equal to pi by 2 plus pi by 4, that is equal to 3 pi by 4 radians. And at 150 degrees, it will be equal to pi by 2 plus pi by 3, that is equal to 5 pi by 6. And at 180 degrees, it will be equal to pi radian. We move further, it will be equal to 210 degrees, where this angle will be equal to 7 pi by 6. Similarly, at 225 degrees, it will be equal to pi plus pi by 4. That will be equal to 5 pi by 4 radians. So we come over to 240 degrees. 240 degrees will be equal to pi plus pi by 3. That is equal to 4 pi by 3 radians. And here it will be equal to 3 pi by 2. That is pi plus pi by 2, that is equal to 3 pi by 2. Similarly, we can take up the angles at, this is 270 degrees, at 300 degrees, and at 315 degrees, and 330 degrees. Similarly, we can find it out. At the end A, it will be equal to 360 degrees, which will be equal to 2 pi radian. This we have taken in anti-clockwise direction, which are taken to be positive angles. Having explained you the positive angles, that is in anti-clockwise direction, if we go in the opposite direction, that is clockwise direction, the angle will automatically be negative. To show you that, we have OA, we go to clockwise direction, that will give you a negative angle. If we take up 30 degrees in the negative direction, that is 30 degrees, it will be taken up as minus 30 degrees because it is in clockwise direction, and it will be equal to minus pi by 6. Similarly, if it is 45 degrees, that is minus 45 degrees, it will be equal to minus pi by 4. If it will be equal to minus 60 degrees, it will be equal to minus pi by 3. At minus 90 degrees, it will be equal to minus pi by 2. At minus 120 degrees, it will be equal to minus 2 pi by 3. At 135 degrees, it will be equal to minus 3 pi by 2. That will be equal to 135, that means pi by 2 plus pi by 4, that is 3 pi by 4. Then at 150 degrees, it will be equal to minus 5 pi by 6. At minus pi, minus 180, it will obviously be equal to minus pi radians. Coming back to minus, that is 180 plus 30 degrees, that is equal to minus 210 degrees, it will be equal to minus pi by 6, that will be equal to minus 7 pi by 6. Similarly, at minus 225 degrees, it will be equal to minus pi plus pi by 4, minus pi plus pi by 4, that will be equal to minus 5 pi by 4. Similarly, at 240 degrees, it will be equal to pi plus pi by 3, that will be equal to minus 4 pi by 3. And minus 270 degrees, it will be equal to minus 3 pi by 2. Similarly, we can find out the angles at 300 degrees and at 315 degrees and at 330 degrees, and then we come over to minus 360 degrees. All these are minus angles which can be calculated accordingly.